Hi everyone, welcome to V2V channel. First of all, thanks being here for my YouTube channel. See, so far I already completed some quant and reasoning topics. So those information available at our channel playlist. So you can check it out our channel playlist. You can get the each and every information related for all the topics what we are already completed. See, in this session we are discussing about some miscellaneous questions regarding time and work. See, who are new to this video, first of all go and watch my previous videos regarding time and work. In those videos, we already discussing 4 to 5 different model of questions related for time and work. So be strong on basics and we can easily solve any questions related for time and work concept. Okay, let's see the miscellaneous question. First of all, see one important concept, and this is the repeated question in a SSA exam. Then see, A and B are two persons. Clear? And A can do the work in A days more than A and B together. B can completed the work in B days more than A and B together. Then how many days does it take A alone can do the work? It means E. So A, B, and the total work is A plus B. If I assume total work is equal to X, and A can completed the work in X plus A, and B can be completed the work in X plus B, and the total work is exactly equal to X. First of all, see, if you identify these ratio, the total work is X plus A into X plus B. In the same information, so A can be completed in X plus B units, B can be completed in X plus A units. Then the total work means X plus A into X plus B divisible by 2X plus A plus B, which is exactly equal to total work X. Then if you cross multiply them, the value become x square plus ax plus bx plus ab exactly equal to 2x square plus ax plus bx. Then see, ax bx cancel. And finally we left with a value of x square is equal to ab. Then x is exactly equal to root over ab. It means see, if any question related for, if a works for A days more than A and B, B works for B days more than A and B, then A, if you want the total work value exactly depends on under the root value of given values of A and B. So this is the direct information, and by using these information you can solve any question related for these model. Okay, let's see the questions. Okay, see the question number one. Here question: A alone would take 27 hours more to complete the work A and B together. So A takes 27 hours together A plus B. B takes 3 hours more than working together by A and B. Then how many days A alone can do it? So according to the previous application, A plus B root value exactly equal to under the root value of A plus B. So this is the value of A and this is the value of B. Then the answer become root over 27 into 3. So root over 27 into 3 become 81. 81 become 9 hours. Here my question: how many days does it take A alone can do the work? So we know that A plus B value become 9. So A takes only for 36 hours. So A takes as a 36 hours. And this is the easy application. See, if you observe the application, we can directly solve without any quadratic equations. Yeah? Then see. Okay, say the same question. A can complete the work in 5 more days than B. 5 days more than B. And while A does the same work in 9 days more than C. And A and B can complete the same work in the same time in C alone can do it. Means A plus B exactly equal to C work. C alone can do it. In how many days A alone can do the same work? Then see. So A, B, C. If I assume C value is equal to X and B value becomes C, if you want A C value is equal to X and A value become 9 plus X. And A value is 5 more than the B means, these value become 4 plus X. Then observe that C value become A plus B. C value become A plus B means, so X can be replaced as A plus B and X can be replaced as A plus B. If you want any combined work, so any combined work exactly equal to root over AB value. So here 4 be the A value, 4, sorry, here A, 9 be the A value and 4 be the B value. Then A plus B value exactly equal to root over 36. Root over 36 value become 6. Then see, A alone can do the work, means 9 plus 6 is equal to 15. If you want B value become 10 and C value become 4. Then see the question. In how many days A alone can complete the same work? So A alone can do the same work in 15 days. Next is the third question. 40 men complete the work in 30 days. 40 men complete the work in 30 days. They start working together. For every after 10 days, 5 men left the work. See, every 10 days, 5 men left the work. See, the total work is 1200 units. 40 men, 30 days means 1200 units. Every 10 days, see, every 10 days, 5 men left. Means, first 10 days, work with 40 men, they are completed 400 units. See, every 10 days, 5 men left means, after 10 days, 5 members are left means, we left with 35 members. So, these 35 members continuously work for 10 days, they are completed 350 units. Again 10 days, after these work, again 5 members left means we left with 30, and these 30 members work with 10 more days, it takes as 300 units. Then see, here next information says that in how much time the work will completed. See, up to here we are completed 1050 units, but we need to complete 1200 units means we left with 150 units. Then see, so after 10 days, again we left with 25 members only. Why? Because 5 members left the work. Means these 25 members working X days, they completed 150 days. Then the value become 150 divisible by 25. So 25 takes as a 6 days. Means these 25 members working 6 days, the whole work is completed. Then see, just in this process, I just take a 36 days to complete the whole work. So answer is a 36 days. See the fourth question. A team of 30 men can do the work in 30 days. 30 men can do the work in 38 days. After 25 days, 5 more men were employed on the work. Due to this, work was completed 1 day earlier. Then see, after 25 days means first 25 days, 30 men are working. Means 30 into 25, they are completed 750 units. Then 5 more men joined. See, 5 more men joined means the total men is 35. So, because of these addition of 5 members, the work is completed 1 day earlier. So, generally work is completed in 38 days. So, because of these 5 members are joined, the work is completed 1 day earlier means the work is completed in 37 days. It means these 35 members works in 12 days. Then see, if 35 into 12, 35 tens are 350, 35 twos are 70. 350 plus 70 value become 420. Means the value become 1170. Here my question. So the total number of units for these work is 1170. If these 5 more men was not added, so how much time delay for these work? It means 1170 units completed by 30 members. Then 00 cancel. 3 3s are 3 9s are. So the work is completed in 39 days. But the work we need to complete in 38 days. So because of these members addition, the work is completed 1 day earlier. If these men is not addition, then delay by 1 day. So the work is delayed by 1 day. Otherwise, see, if you want to go with the direct work, see, here extra members are 5. So 5 members working 12 days means 5 into 12. So the extra men, they completed 60 units. If these 60 units done by these 30 people, 60 units done by 30 people, it takes only for 2 days. So generally work is completed in 37 days. If these two more men is not added, the work is completed in 39 days. Then see, actually we need to complete it 38, but the work is completed in 39, means the delay by 1 day. See, just consider extra work divisible by original people, we get the 2 days. If these 37 addition plus 2 days, the value become 39. Originally we need to complete it in 38 days, but here we are completed in 39, means the work is delayed by 1 day. Okay, see the 5th question. A contractor finish a road in 40 days with 100 men. 40 days with 100 men. After 35 days, he employed 100 more men in the work, finish on time. Then see, after 35 days means first 35 days, with 100 men, the value become 3,500 units. After 35 days, he employed 100 more men, means their total employees are 200. They working on time, means they working only for 5 days. Why? Because 35 plus 5 become 40 days. Means they are completed 1000 units. Means the entire work is 4,500 units. Here my question. If those 100 men was not employed, if those 100 men are not employed, means first 100 employees are working. For 4,500 units of work can done by 100 members in 45 days. Then see, so originally the work is completed in 40 days, but here the work is completed in 45 days. Means the work is delayed by 5 days. Okay, then see, if you want to go with the direct one, see, here we are excess with 100 employee, those 100 employee working in 5 days. Means those excess employees of 100 member working in 5 days means they are completed 500 units. And these excess work, so these excess work completed by old people of 100 members, it takes for 5 days. So generally work is completed on time. If these 5 members are not employed, the work is delayed by 5 days. Focus on the excess value. So those excess value can define as a delay of work. And these are the different questions related for time and work in a miscellaneous part. Thank you.